everybody, welcome back to The Binding of Isaac Afterbirth Plus. We're playing as Apollon. Here's a scene for you. L7FK2CQE. We're starting off with Judas's shadow, which I'll be honest with you, I really don't think is good for us to take. We need to do Mega Satan with the old Apollon. So, is there really a reason to take Judas's shadow when we don't really want to become Dark Judas? I think the answer to that is no. Hopefully we'll be able to reroll it. Push comes to shove, we will void it and get a statistical benefit from it. But hopefully we just get a better item in its place. I'm trying to figure out why my game is lagging like a hella today. What in the world is going on? Okay, let me check some stuff. Is there some shenanigans going on in here? It doesn't seem so. Let's try that. And let's see if that makes a difference. It seems to have made a difference. We're going to roll with it. Fine by me, I suppose. We need to make it to the dark room. We need to stack up as much HP as we possibly can so that we can possibly play a self-sacrifice room in order to get our needs for the key pieces. Can we get some money out of this guy, please? Pretty please. I know that I can get shots in there. It's breaking. It'll break soon, don't you worry. Just like my sanity, that's gonna break soon as well. Here we go. Beautiful. That's a good amount of money. Can we sneak that one? Nah, there we go. Okay, let's go back. Let's re-roll our item as much as we can. We could go to the shop with this money, but we also don't have a key, so that seemingly becomes a well, okay, you've now tricked me, but that's okay. We're still going to use our money to reroll this. Abel is not good enough. Punching bag is not good enough. Booger Tears is really good, actually. I had to think for a second of what that was, but now that I see it, I know I want it. I know you want it. I would really love to pick up Mom's Key here, but I highly, highly doubt we're going to pick up enough money to do so. Unless we get Pageant Boy here, and then even then, the chance is still a little bit low. Just let the Booger Tears do their thing, man. It's a great item, honestly. It makes clearing bosses a hell of a lot easier. Do we want to try to explore a little bit in an attempt to get some extra money? I think the answer to that is actually a probable yeah. You know, if we can get 10 cents out of nowhere, Mom's Key is a huge upgrade for us. Instead, we have the opportunity to get possibly an HP upgrade, which would not be horrible at this stage in the game. Red HP is okay. Instead, we just get a key. That's not going to do too much for us. Let's just head down, get on to the next floor. The deal with the devil is going to be important. We have no spirit heart protection, but we do have a pretty damn decent, pretty damn decent room clearer with our beautiful Booger Tears right now. So I'm feeling confident. It's early in the morning. It's like 9:30. Yeah, it's 9:30. That's earlier than I would normally. Well, not now. I record Isaac a lot earlier now, but in the past it's a lot earlier. So I gotta warm up my brain a little bit with my Isaac in the morning. Gets me going for the day. I would love a bomb so we could actually blow up, you son of a gun. I did not see two spiders just chilling right there. I would love to blow up that tinted rock, get some benefit out of it. I would also love to void the unicorn horn, so we're gonna do that. I would love to get battery charge before the deal with the devil, even though there's a slight chance we ain't getting that deal with the devil. Can we come in here? Man, BFF would be so good as well. Give me money. That's like the number one concern of this run, is whether or not you want to give me money. Well, there's one penny. The game's lagging again. What in the world is going on today? I promise you, I restarted my computer. It should be ready for the day, man. It only lags on certain rooms. I don't know. Who knows? Maybe it's something to do with what I got running in the background. Let's, like, come over here. Let's close that. Let's close that. I mean, that's basically everything that needs to be closed. We'll see if it runs better. It seems to be running better. I don't know, man. Usually a game like The Binding of Isaac, my computer can handle recording, but apparently not today. We did get a deal with the devil, that's nice. And it contains two really subpar items, if I'm being honest with you. We are going to take the flight just to provide some benefit for our run here. But otherwise, that's fairly disappointing in the grand scheme of things. We are going to attempt to gain more benefit from this floor, such as finding just several bombs. Wow, this floor is killing it. Let's go back to the arcade. We will spend some time. This is what we needed. Now we will spend some time playing this guy so that we can get into our mob trap room. And that's now a decent amount of money, which I love. Come in here, two chests. I think this is worth doing. We get a bomb. That's the true ticket right here. And I think that this is a decent spot to be in. You know what? Pop this. Just say goodnight to him. And then it's going to be some gurglings. Say goodnight to them as well. Okay. This is good. We can now go back to the shop. We can buy BFF. Hopefully BFF provides us value later on in this run. But we also have two bombs now that we can use to blow up Tinted Rocks, which will give us HP or, you know, in the best case scenario, Small Rock. But we will see. A bomb and a Spirit Heart is A-okay. Should I blow up some pots? I think you blow up these just because we have the secret room right here. What do you think? Do you think we'll get a bomb back from this? I feel like we will. Steam sale, though, is actually 10 times better. So I'm glad that that happened. Come in here. 7-cent BFF is good. Then let's pour some money into this guy. Rerolls. I think you take Humbling Bundle. Can we get one more item out? Pandora's Box will give us... I don't know. Let's pop it. That's a good value, in my opinion. That sounds good to me. We can now, let's blow up this guy. 3-cent Diplopia? I mean, that seems like something that we should inquire to do. I just don't know where I'm getting 3 cents from, besides going back and playing the, thingamajiggy. Although, is it really worth it to get... Screw it. Let's just head down. We are a little bit slow right now on time. Alright, well that's like stupidly huge, getting Goathead this early on the run. We're looking to be in a pretty good spot. I like the fact we have Steam Sale this early, and obviously having Goathead this early is also, beautiful in every way. James Blunt style. Please don't do that to me right now. But, deal with the devil, rest of the run, very good. Also, Steam Sale allows the shops to be great. Make the shops in Isaac great again. I'm feeling confident. This is good. Now, we do still need... I'm going to focus this run around Mega Satan, but that shouldn't distract you from the fact that, one, the Warriors blew a 3-1 lead in the NBA Finals, but also it shouldn't distract you from the fact that we need to still do a looping run. I don't know if that's something that I want to do on this one. I'd rather crank out Mega Satan... and then do just like an Isaac run to try to get the looping darkroom thing going. I haven't actually done any looping situations yet, so it's going to be a new experience for me to try out the looping run. And I think you need to loop like 5 times or something like that to get one of the achievements. So we're going to have to get like really powerful, and that's something that I need a good character to do. Not that Apollon isn't a good character, I think he is a good character. I just like, when you play as Isaac, you can usually spiral out of control fairly quickly. So that's kind of what I'm banking for right now, is doing a looping Isaac run to spiral out of control. Booger Tears is still putting in the work. Magic Mush? No, but a good trinket. So we will happily take it. You think this is our secret room? I'll be damned, it is. What a time to be alive. What do we want from it? Honestly, give me money. That's like the number one thing that can be in here. Instead, you give me a double paralysis. And I can see forever, which I suppose is okay. Let's come play this guy. And by play, I mean blow up. This is good. I can't help but notice that if we get a random greed fight and he pops out Steam Sale, We're going to have free shops for the rest of the run. So basically, as long as we can get restock, we won the game. And in that case, I probably would go with the looping run, since that would provide us the best chance at winning, is, you know, having every single item in the game. So we'll figure out what happens here. Obviously, getting double Steam sale plus restock isn't exactly a common occurrence, so I'm not going to bank on that happening. But restock this early is, you know, a huge benefit on a run. Let's pop in here real quick. No, there's no reason for us to do that. Let's just continue on. We still have an item room to find. Here's our shop. I think it is valuable to go into the shop. It's not inconceivable to find 4 cents on a run. And we can't see what the items are, so part of me is kind of like, let's not worry about that. But then the other part of me is like, we have a ton of money, so why not just worry about that and do that? This could be incredibly good. There's our deal with the devil. We're going to get it anyway, so we will take those here soon, because we have the spirit hearts to take them. Bombs are key. I'm actually really okay with that. And we also got a puberty pill, which I'm very okay with, because we can get HP from that eventually with the adult transformation. So that's good. Give me 2 more puberty pills. I would love to become adult Isaac on this run. Not that it's, you know, a super benefit, but it does give HP, so that's an okay situation to be in. We take this, it's Binky, which is a good tiers upgrade. We take this, which is Book of Belial. We take this, which is Rotten Baby. And then you void right here to get Book of Belial. Not that that's going to provide a ton of benefit for us, but it is a spacebar item that we can void, so why not roll with it, I suppose. I can see the damage already starting to come to a point where I can recognize it. You know, little chubby, there we go. That's really gonna benefit us a lot. But honestly, BFF is a huge pickup for us with the old Rotten Baby. You know what, let's go buy that item from the shop. It can't be anything bad, right? There's options. I mean, that's basically like an ideal item as a pollen. So this is good. I wish I would have known that before, because we probably could have avoided the stuff. But Binky is very good, so I'm fairly okay with this decision. Let's just head down. Boss Rush is something that I would, you know, very much so inquire to. We'll take Locust of Conquest, because frankly, I don't know what the Locust items do quite yet, so I might as well try them out. Tractor Beam, I think, is worth it. If we get some kind of double shot, triple shot kind of strategy going on, then Tractor Beam is always worth. It can be a fairly fun item. So this is a good chance to use some items we don't often use, such as the Locust of Wrath right now. I know it gives special flies, I just don't know exactly what those special flies are. I also recognize we're a little low on HP, but we won't be forever. We'll be able to get some spirit hearts as we go along here. I'm pretty powerful, so I'm not overly concerned about the state of the run. Also the state of the Union, but we are all pretty concerned about that one. We'll pop in here real quick. I mean, I would love to play this guy, but it's just not really conceivable, so we'll blow him up. I mean, Dim Bulb is very good, but it's not really super great for our kind of setup with the Void, since a lot of the time we do have a full charge on it. Let's Void him. That's not really the best Void in the world, but I kind of am of the opinion that whenever you get a spacebar item and you're holding the Void, you gotta suck it. No matter what, even if it's terrible, you suck, because suck is love and suck is life, I suppose. But that's okay. Let's, we did not find our item room yet, so that's a benefit. We will have more, or there's options for the boss fight. So we want to make sure we have a full charge on, well, we always want to make sure we have a full charge on the Void before going to the shot, or going to the boss fight, just in case the deal with the devil has something like Satanic Bible or the Nail. What do we got in here? PhD. PhD is fine. 2 of clubs is fine. Let's take the spirit heart. Relax is not good enough. I mean, in reality, 2 cents for two bombs is a honestly great trade. But we really don't need the bombs right now. So why even bother taking them is kind of my opinion in this. I'm not overly concerned about consumables on this one. We have Humbling Bundle. We're going to be getting a ton of consumables throughout this run. So that is a-okay. I went to the gym the other day. And, yeah, I know, right? Me going to the gym. But, I went to the gym and I was just shooting some hoops, playing some basketball. I think I, like, managed to sprain both of my arms. Because I literally, like, have not played basketball. For those that don't know, like, I'm a huge basketball fan and I enjoy playing it a lot. But I have not played in, like, months. And, when you go and use muscles that you haven't used in a long time, there's a decent chance that's gonna cause you some pain. I think I have caused myself some pain, and my arms kind of feel like they're going to fall off, but that's beside the point. We are going to suck these up. As a plus 2.95 damage upgrade, that's really good, man. Let's head down. There's no reason to stay here, at least none that I can remember, so I'm content getting the hell out of here and getting down on the next floor. Boss rush is still totally an option. Never doing physical activity is another option for me. Probably not the best option, but it is an option nonetheless. I mean, this is like your ideal situation in our setup, is to get a ton of fires that you can get spirit hearts from. I mean, yeah, we basically walked out of this room getting like 8 spirit hearts. That's a pretty good trade, if I'm going to be honest with you. Spend 1 bomb, get 8 spirit hearts. That's like a tinted rock on crack. I love every second of that. I still, though, you'd think that, like, exercise, they always say exercise is good for you. I was like, you know what? Today's the day. I'm going over, I'm exercising. What do? I hurt myself in my confusion. What you gonna do, I suppose? We do want everything in here. We want this first. Emperor is awesome. And then we do want to get a charge and then come back, buy the smelter, and then void that guy. That way we have Locust of Wrath for the rest of the run, and we can also get any other trinkets that we so desire. And let's be honest, there are a lot of good trinkets in the game. Plus, I love the Void Smelter duo. We had it on, I believe, the last run as well. It's been a little while since I recorded the last run, so I don't know. Let's buy that. Void that guy. Places a bomb. That's okay. Oh, we're getting the plus 2.95 damage from the Book of Belial. That wasn't from voiding those two items on the last floor. I probably should have recognized that, but YOLO, at least I figured it out now. We still have an item room to find, but we're going to fight the Fallen here first. And it doesn't really matter that we don't have a full charge on the Void, because the deal with the Devil will stay open. So this is fine. I honestly think you suck both of those as well. Never mind. You totally don't suck the one. You take Guppy's Hairball. Because now we are one Guppy item away from Guppy, which does provide very monstrous benefits for us on a run. But let's go look for the item room. We got time. I do want to make it to boss rush. That is a concern of mine. But we have the Emperor card. If we really need to on the next floor, we could teleport straight to the boss fight and do boss rush. I really do feel like boss rush is like basically a incredibly valuable thing as a pollen. Just because, like, no matter what, you're walking out of there with benefit. You know, some characters you rush to get the boss rush, and then the items are crap. In our case, we're going to rush to get there, and no matter what, we're getting stat increases. Somehow, or, you know, just a really good item, which could involve a stat increase. Look, I don't know, man. Don't let me tell you how to live your life. You make your own destiny. You are the number one. You also are the only exception, and you are something, something, something. Okay, what is this? Luck up. Luck up is good. We now have 2 luck. One singular 2 luck, which is good. I'm very happy about it. Item room, please. I would like it if somewhere along the line today we could actually find the item room, but apparently that's too much to ask. Okay, please don't ever get hit by a fire ever again. We have now spent a significant amount of time trying to find this damn item room. So if it sucks, you know that I'm going to be salty. Here's the item room. You walk in. Midas Touch is so good, but we're going to void it. We got a luck upgrade from it, so I'm pretty okay with that. Please be the secret room. It was. Okay, please don't do anything to me and then let me go. Okay, this is good. Let's head down to the next floor. It is going to be our deal with the devil floor. Which, or our boss rush floor, not our deal with the devil. Well, we're going to get a deal with the devil too. But it is our boss rush floor. So once again, if we don't find the boss by like 9:30, then I will use the teleport card. But I would really like it if we could find the boss before there, so I can use the teleport card to literally get out of boss rush. The shop should be of my like utmost concern right now with the money that we have and also the item room, but I figured that was self-explanatory. And we are clearing through these rooms pretty fast right now. We did find the boss. We're going to backtrack a little bit in the hopes of finding the item room slash shop. And I have a feeling that we're going to have the shop to our left. Okay, there's the shop. I wouldn't mind a greed fight right now. Instead, we get the Plopia. And if this card is... Well, that's unfortunate. I would really, really like it if we could bring Diplopia into boss rush. And then also find some way to teleport back out so we could pick up the void. I know if we void Diplopia, we will not be able to use it in boss rush. So this is a unique situation. I don't know what to do. Let's just void Diplopia. I know it's not going to work how Tyler desires it to work, but we're going to do it anyway. This allows us to now have, well, we got to book it to Mom, and we're going to have to beat Mom very quickly, which is possible, but it is a little bit on the sketch side. If we don't make boss rush, then everything I've done is a failure here. Because we're going to miss out on our item room for no good reason. And it's looking like that's actually going to happen. Please don't let that happen. Let me make it to... Nope. We missed it. Alright, so this was a big old pile of failure. We do get the deal with the devil. We got to take the negative. Deal contains the nail. I mean, that's a very good item to... Did I botch this? No, I didn't botch this. That's what we were supposed to do, is right there. Okay, just head down. Get the hell out of this floor. No reason for us to stay here. I do accept this woman to be my bride, but I do want to do this entire womb floor, because now we're kind of in the process of looking for self-sacrifice rooms. I mean, we really truly need to get these key pieces if we're going to fight Mega Satan. And there's no way that we don't get a self-sacrifice room, like, three floors in a row. So we gotta start searching for them now, so that we can ensure that we have them. I mean, I can't lie to you. One Guppy item would really go a long way for us right now. We'd be popping out flies like it's our job. Those are gonna be doing good damage. You know, I enjoy the tractor beam lump of coal setup we got right now. But I can't help but notice we literally have not gotten any other damage ups from this run. It's just a little odd. Right? No damage ups? I don't think so, man. We got some, like, tiers ups. You know, our tier stat is fine, but straight damage, we haven't gotten anything. We're just sitting at basically base damage. I think we got a couple of upgrades from voiding stuff. But you kind of, like, you need more than that on a run, man. Part of me very much so wants to come in here and then just teleport out of it. So we'll see what happens. Crack into these. A lot of money. Let's just teleport out. It's going to be Mama Gertie. Mama Gertie is not a problem when you have flight, because the spikes aren't going to do anything. So I'm feeling confident. She's not going to be able to hit us, honestly. It's going to be a flawless fight for us. Beautiful days. The halo's really good, but I would probably suck both of those. And then Incubus is obviously a must pick up kind of item here. I also do recognize that we are now sitting in a position where, I mean, do you take the all stats up? We could, let's take the all stats up. It's going to give us a little bit of damage. I think more importantly, it's going to give us a little bit of HP right now. If we're going to be spending a lot of our HP because it deals with the devil, then we want to at least have some red HP. Especially when we don't have an item that, you know, needs to not have red HP. I'm pretty okay with that. Okay. Tinted rocks? No tinted rocks. That's fine. Card is the Joker. I mean, that's basically if we do the Hush fight, which I'm leaning towards doing because we have the keys and the money to make value out of it. Then there's a decent chance that we will just pop the Joker on the Hush fight. I also recognize that I'm literally doing the Hush fight to try to gain benefit from it, and that's usually the number one, like, don't do that when playing Isaac, is thinking that Hush will benefit you. But I do feel like this is the kind of run where Hush provides benefit for us. It definitely doesn't work if you die, but we do have 8 lives. Let's just get out of this floor now. I don't know why I just backtracked into this room. Maybe it'll give us something incredible. Nah, it gave us a battery charge. Get the hell out of this floor. This has been a toxic floor so far. So let's just head down. It's a happy day. We are fine. Okay. Utero 2. I thought that was the boss fight for a second, and I was like, what in the world is this floor? But no, it's not. This is fine. We have a Joker card. There's no reason for us to pop it on this floor. We're going to get a deal with the devil. If this gives us a Steam sale, it didn't. It would have been really dope if it did. And then restock from the Hush shop. Re-hush. Double key room. Bunch of poop. That's very, very, very useless for us. But I'm not complaining. That's okay. Please don't actually ever die ever again, Tyler. I'm starting to kind of be concerned about the fact that we're not getting any HP on this run. That's what happens when you trade away a lot of it and deals with the devil. We're down to 6 lives. Have I really botched this one this bad? You know what? We should be popping the void whenever we get the opportunity now. Because we're getting... Oh, now that's the good stuff right there. We're getting spirit hearts from it because of the nails. So that's completely my bad for not doing that. But we need to start popping the void whenever, wherever now. Don't worry about, you know, sucking stuff up right now. Just worry about getting yourself some HP. You know, it's one thing if we find a self-sacrifice room, but if we're not able to play it, then that's kind of like inconsequential towards our run. Now, we should pop the void inside of rooms so that we can utilize the invincibility from it. But I did not actually realize that guy was still alive. But otherwise, it's like still an okay situation to be in. We have so many consumables on this run. Don't think of that as me complaining. Think of it as me being pleasantly confused by it. But otherwise, everything going a-okay up in the club. Everybody in the club getting tipsy. Should we explore the rest of this floor in order to look for a self-sacrifice room? The answer to that is a probable yeah. Featuring Usher and Ludacris. But let's do Mom first. Get this fight over with. And then we can run back. We do get the deal. The deal contains Headless Baby, which is not good enough. So instead, we just run back and let's figure some stuff out for if we can get a self-sacrifice room on this floor. We also want to pop the void right in the next room, right in this room. And I would love, love, love if there was a red chest in here. There's not. That's fair. Just trying to look for that last Guppy item, man. You get Goathead, you kind of expect to be Guppy by the end of it. But that's not exactly how this has worked. Bombs are key. I mean, that's basically like, you know, who cares kind of a situation. Alright. We took damage. I don't think there's a self-sacrifice room on this floor. So we're basically like now just hoping that the cathedral has one. But we might have just screwed ourselves out of a Mega Satan win. Which means that we're going to have to play even more Apollon. We are going to go fight Hush because I think that this will provide benefit for us. Now we got 99 cents. I got 99 problems, but these cents ain't one. We can come in here. Teleport 2.0. It's definitely weird. So I probably would want to do that. I don't really think Mom's Knife is good either here. I kind of want to suck like all this stuff. Take Deep Pockets. Take Hangman. I think you just, you know, donate a bunch here. Compost would also be like acceptable to suck up, but it's not like my number one concern right now. We will pop the Joker here shortly. But I want to donate as much as we can. We've already, like, we've been donating a lot lately. Getting this machine back up to a reasonable place is beautiful. We also got some luck upgrades from that. I think you take Sack of Pennies, because that's not our number one suck candidate here. And then I think this is the number one suck candidate. You know, and part of me wants to take Mom's Knife. I suppose we should take Mom's Knife. Because we really don't have too much in terms of synergies on this run. So let's pop Joker. That gives us the Guppy transformation. That's now like pretty huge. But we have Mom's Knife. Some people are going to be mad that I took it. But it's going to make this Hush fight go significantly quicker. And then if we pop these, that teleports us into Hush. And then we can just start tearing onto this guy. Incubus plus Mom's Knife is not incredible, but it's still like pretty okay. Why did I choose to slam my body into this guy? That's a really good question. It seemed like the right idea at the time. I recognize now it probably wasn't. This should be an easy Hush fight. And then we can head up to the cathedral in the hopes of finding a self-sacrifice room there. If we do end up getting these key pieces somehow, or getting a... Oh, we're not going to the cathedral. We're going to the dark room. Make sure that I don't go to the cathedral. I know I've been saying that a lot, but make sure I don't do that. I say that to you as if you actually control what I'm doing, as this video will probably come out 2 weeks after I record it. That's beside the point. We need to go down to Sheol, not dark room, or not cathedral. I'm screwing myself up here, man. Okay, Hush is already like biting the dust hardcore, which is a good place to be in. We're tearing apart most of his people as well. I mean, this is our ideal like Hush attack, because we're just going to continue to pour in damage as he does mindless attacks. And we're very close to finishing this fight. Guppy's freaking hairball is blocking all of Hush's shots. That's a new one. We actually got benefit out of Guppy's hairball. 4 HP, but we have 6 lives, so I'm not overly concerned about our situation here. And overall, pretty confident about getting the win on this run. It's just confidence about getting Mega Satan on this run that I'm a little concerned about. So Hush is done. We can head down to Sheol. And now it's just do every floor in the hopes of finding that self-sacrifice room. And then also try to gain HP throughout this process. Because there's no way that we're getting what we need in terms of the key pieces with 4 spirit hearts. That's just not going to happen. Suck that. We can get a error room on this floor because we suck teleport 2.0. I realize that now. Do we want to do that? That's a really good question. I think the answer to that is no, but we'll figure that out as time goes on. It is very dark. Curse of the Darkness on Sheol is a big slap in the face. but we will make the best of it. This rock just... I swear to God, that rock flickered like it would be a crawl space. And I couldn't remember if we picked up a trinket that we smelted or anything. Well, Ace of Hearts provides benefits. We'll fool to save some HP here. But Ace of Hearts could... I don't know what this does. Muconium. We'll take it. We'll be able to smelt it. But Ace of Hearts, we could get Spirit Hearts from, theoretically. We can also just get Spirit Hearts from these fires, but that's the seemingly obvious approach here. Let's Ace of Hearts here. Okay, it didn't do what we wanted. We teleport out. We don't want to use the damn thing anymore inside of rooms because we're just going to teleport out of them. You tell me that I can't get those fires? That's a little disappointing. How about now? Catch me outside. How about now? Okay, what is this? Pheromones, relax. Both very useless. I would love another Hierophant card. That was a fun time when we got that. Battery charge. We will pop, but not yet. Also, horrible damage by me. Not our super secret room. Here's our boss fight. We should probably just fight the boss now, but then we have our due diligence to do on this floor still. Beautiful. That didn't actually work the way that I intended it to, but what are you going to do? It worked out fine. This is like the fourth time I've fought Satan in a week, and then, like, before that, I don't think I've fought Satan in, like, 5 months. So I'm used to this fight. I took a little bit of damage, but that's okay. Two pennies. We are going to head back. We're basically looking for the opportunity to get a self-sacrifice room. But we're also going to attempt to get an error room out of this as well. So let's look for a super secret room. It could be here. It could be here. No, secret room can't be there. Because if we can get the error room, I'm not positive exactly what that's going to do for us, but not the secret room. I'm not positive what the error room could give us or where we'd go from it. That confuses me a little bit. But I still want to attempt to get it. And who knows, there's still a chance that a self-sacrifice room sits at the end of this. However, we really do not have the HP to do it right now. What is this? Bombs? This seems like a super secret. No. Okay. Why is this hallway so long, friend? Satan, what up with your hallways, man? Do you think Satan has good interior decorating? I feel like there's a chance he does. No self-sacrifice room. So, the Mega Satan dreams are basically dead here. We are still going to look for the super secret room. And the regular secret room at this rate. Because we should be able to get the, can we bomb in here? There we go. We should be able to get the error room, if it's possible. Oh, we'll get a deal with the devil. Now, if we find the super secret room, we should be able to get the error room as well. Because then that would... I suppose the super secret could be here. No, I have a feeling it's in the last room. But we have a battery charge, so we'll be able to... There it is. Okay, just pills, perks a lot of times, luck up. Okay, so now popping the battery will bring us to deal with the devil. Contains a lot of stuff we really don't need, so I'm not going to take it. This will bring us to the error room. It contains HP, which is fine. Hangman, tower, temperance, two of diamonds, useless. Let's just blow up that guy, get some money out of it. Tower, temperance, sure, blow those up. There's a spirit heart back. Now, does this bring us back to... No, this brings us straight to... the dark room. Okay, that's fine. Crack into these. There's a decent chance that these are, cursed eye. Now, Guppy's paw. That's actually really good to have. Cursed Eye? Guppy's Tail. Okay, so we basically have the entire Guppy transformation, all freaking five. And Guppy's Tail is actually huge here, because we're going to be getting chests, and we have plenty of keys. But we're going to be getting chests, and we can maybe get Dad's key from one. How does that sound? It sounds pretty good to me. So we'll hope for the best here. We do have Curse of the Blind, so we don't really know what we're going to get. Glaucoma. I'll be honest with you, really didn't need glaucoma on this one. It's a mom's knife run. Glaucoma is very useless. But I appreciate the thought. Thought's all that counts. I suppose take Guppy's Paw and void it. Why not? We're going to be getting HP. It's not going to benefit us after this next red heart, but we really don't need the red hearts anymore. Dead Tooth, I don't... Well, it creates this weird aura around us, but it's not really too useful for us at this stage of the game. Come on, Dad's Key. Pinking Shears. I mean, that's definitely a suck candidate. Suck candidate 2017. But not also my number one concern right now. Beautiful, beautiful. I don't really mind taking damage. We have a lot of HP. Also a, not contract from below, but a... What the hell is the name of that card? Get out of jail free. What in the world? Somebody just screamed at the top of their lungs outside. Got a little hushy. What a time to be alive. But if we can get a get out of jail free card, then that also gives us the ability to open up the Mega Satan door. So that's beneficial. Glowing Hourglass, I don't think is any reason whatsoever that we pop the void on that. Let's just use the moon. It brings us to a bunch of money. That's fine. Crack into this room. We should try to loop if we can. Because all we'll do is just guarantee that we get... And by loop, I mean loop with Monster Manual. Not loop with Monster Manual. Loop with Teleport 2.0. So that we can potentially... We just picked up Isaac's freaking heart. Oh, that's a really bad position to be in. Okay, well, this run just got, like, 10 times sketchier, if I'm being honest with you. Isaac's heart's no joke, man. Sad bombs. I mean, sad bombs are awesome. Except for when I blow myself up with them. That's really frustrating. But if we can swing, you know, finding the super secret room on this floor... Getting a battery charge, getting the deal with the devil, and then going to an error room. I would love to see what happens. I know they took out looping with Undefined. But did they remove looping with Teleport 2.0? It's a good question. I also am slowly losing HP. D7. That's an interesting item, actually, but we're not going to take it. I feel like we could be able to basically like create infinite items here. But I'm not positive, so I'm not going to try. Spelunker Hat. We're getting so many just absolute subpar items. Which I'm not complaining about because we're overpowered as hell anyway. But, really, it wouldn't be that bad if you just popped out Dad's Key. We could have a good talk about it. Make me really happy. Open up that Mega Satan door. Feel real good. What do we got here? Epiphora. Fairly useless in the grand scheme of things. We did actually die. We have HP still, though. It basically, we're going to fight the lamb. You got to be kidding me. We're going to fight the lamb. If we don't beat the lamb, just pop a tower card. Wow. 10 out of 10, Tyler. If we don't beat the lamb, then... Or if we beat the lamb is what... Why in the world have I died this many times on this damn run? Okay, please. It's two big chubs. This is not that difficult, Tyler. But when we beat the lamb, we are going to get... Host Hat's pretty good, actually. When we beat this guy, we're going to get the achievement for beating him and the post-it for beating him. And that's really all that I'm, like, super concerned about. You know, going back and finding a way to get Mega Satan is just, you know, added bonus. I almost bit the dust right there. He should be dead here shortly. Try to get a knife in there. Knife bomb. Bomb knife. I haven't fought this guy in a hot second. Okay. Please. You're almost dead. And you gotta be kidding me. You have gotta be actually kidding me. Okay. This is fine. Chuck in some bombs. They don't hurt us. They only hurt him. Put in bombs. He's feeling the damage. He's feeling the damage. He's feeling it. Are you feeling it now, Mr. Lamb? Alright, well, I'm feeling a little bit sketchy. So we're going to teleport a little bit. That gives us our spirit hearts because of Guppy's paw and also the other thing that we have. The nail is the word I wanted. Can't help but notice we just took some hits there. Ghost baby, that's going to make all the difference. Happy to have it. And then let's just, you know, take two here. We don't need that. Chuck in bombs. Beautiful. Just place a bunch of them, honestly. Why are people screaming out in the quad still? That's, like, really annoying. Okay. Just dodge. I have not showcased my greatest Isaac skills in this video. We've gotten fairly lucky by receiving good items. But the skills have not been on display. Okay, just stand on him. And he's dead. Okay, would I like to do a victory lap? The answer to that is no. Because I want to still try to get Mega Satan. We'll do the victory lap on another video. There's still a prayer somewhere in my mind that we can get this damn... We should bomb this in the hopes of a spirit heart. We actually did get one. There's still some prayer in my mind that we can pick up. Well, no, it's gone. This floor is practically over unless we get Dad's key dropping from a chest. No. I was going to say, that would be one hell of a comeback here. There's our super secret room. Contains black poop. I mean, that's going to do it. Sadly, we're going to have to do another Apollon run to try to get the Mega Satan going. But nonetheless, this still worked out fine, I suppose. If I have to. But there's not much we can do here. We might as well just head down, say goodnight to this run. It shouldn't ask me for a victory lap again right now. We're done. Go on in. That's going to do it. We unlocked the Locust of Death, which I suppose is good. But otherwise, I'm kind of just like, eh. If you enjoyed, leave a like, leave a comment, subscribe. I'll see you guys next time. Bye.